Jürgen, first of all, can we get your reaction to the Europa League draw, please?
Tricky. Atlanta, we played there. Super. It's not that I've watched them since then 500 times, but still the same manager. Pretty sure similar structure, so it means uncomfortable to play against, very well organized. But it's quarterfinal. Didn't expect, it was not possible actually with all the teams involved, didn't expect any easy opponent. So very interesting, really looking forward to it. Let's see what we can do, but a lot of respect for what Atalanta is doing in the last years. Very consistent, so good.
I mean, the other day as well, you said, Gareth, come on, in reference to Joe Gomez. And now he's back in the England squad.
I don't think there's a lot of, but that had a lot of influence. It was unnecessary, yeah? So Joe deserves it, obviously, absolutely. What a season he plays so far, so it's absolutely exceptional. So a lot of times without the kids, we were not where we are. Without Joey, we would be definitely not where we are in the moment. He played so many different positions. Really happy for him and good. I saw in his face he was very happy about it as well. So good news. Yeah, and now let's play the game and then he can go there and then he hopefully comes back healthy and we can play the rest of the season.
Last night, with regard to the changes, you said you started thinking about Manchester United during the game. Don't think we often hear that from a manager, even when a tie is won. But does that kind of sum up the importance of this game to you against United and also the importance of looking after your players?
So we are 4-0 up and 5-1. So that's the moment when you think, okay, then we take off now, X, Y and Z. I don't think we would have played Robbo as a centre-half if it's 0-0 or we are 2-0 down. So not, but he did exceptionally well, by the way. So the next one who opened the door for a new position. But that's the only reason for it. That's really strange. You cannot believe that you're 4-0 or 4-1 then up at half time. Was it half time? Yeah, at half time 4-1 up and on aggregate obviously 9-2. So even the biggest pessimist would not think that we will not go through to the next round. So that was because of that. No other reason. Usually you really have no time and no resources to think about the next game. But that's why we did the changes. We made the changes we made.
Just check, because Mo's got a great record against United. So is he fine after 90 minutes? How's Konate and how's Bobby Clark as well?
Yeah, Mo is definitely ready. Ibu didn't train today. We have to see if he can train tomorrow, but will be a tight race, which we probably lose, but we don't know. Bobby felt much better. That was uncomfortable, got knocked there, little swelling, and that swelling led to the feeling that there might be something more serious, but it's not. So he's fine. Yeah, that's it. Ryan trained today again, so he's ready as well. And the others, some of the others after international break.
Hi, Jürgen. Do you enjoy these kind of ties? I mean, there's a lot of intensity and rivalry and history. Is it possible to enjoy the challenge of a game like this?
I'm looking forward to it. I'm not sure if that's exactly what you call enjoyment, but I'm looking forward to it. So it's a good thing. Come on, we can take 9,000 people, I think. More tickets, 9,000 people, Old Trafford, Manchester United. Yeah, that's definitely. Ask me after the game if I enjoyed it. But before the game, it's just work, and we try to be as good prepared as somehow possible. Yeah, it's the situation that now we played again on Thursday, but I would say yesterday. But it's we could handle it, and United had obviously a full week to prepare. Erik ten Hag is a really good manager. He will prepare them. He knows exactly how we play. So we will face there some challenges we don't know in the moment. That's how it is. We don't have this time to prepare like this for an opponent and have to be ready anyway. So yes, as much as it is possible, I enjoy it.
A lot's been made, obviously, of the season that United are having, but it seems to be one of those fixtures and games that comes outside of the normal sort of form guide. And obviously they have home advantage, so it's going to be a big challenge.
I don't know too much about their season. But I saw a few really, really good games. There's a lot of quality there. They had injury problems, obviously, as well, but a lot of quality. I don't know which player is available. Maybe Rasmus Højlund is available again. Maybe who else is close? I think Wan-Bissaka and some others. So, which were not available recently, that obviously makes a difference as well. We will see that on Sunday. But again, it was always a tough place to go for us. It's not easy. It means everything to both fan groups. Means absolutely everything. We know that. We try to show that on the pitch as well with the work rate. But you never know. So there are no guarantees, just opportunities. That's how we see it, and we were really willing to give it a try.
Yeah.
Hi,
Jürgen. Hi.
United are the only team in the last 55 games to stop you scoring that goal was through at Anfield. Just really, with them playing at home, do you think that offers you a bit more opportunity? They're going to have to be a bit more forthcoming, and you've got the results.
I don't know at the moment if we can play the same game again. It was a really good game. I would call this game the start when we really reach the next level in the season. I think until then it was always a little bit, yes, we were quite okay, didn't lose a lot of games. We lost only once before. But it was still sometimes really good, sometimes not so good. It was difficult to judge us, let me say like that, because we had so many things to overcome, like red cards, being 1-0 down or whatever, all these kind of things. So it was not always clear how good actually are we. And that game, our first time I saw, poof, yes, that was really us in the next gear. Yes, result didn't show that. Well, I have no clue if that will be the same game or not. I don't expect it. Obviously, it's a home game for them. But a lot of aspects in our game that they were really, really good. Really good. And that's these aspects we try to bring on the pitch again. But how is that? The opponent had a full week to prepare. They might do a few things differently. And then we have to adapt to that.
Jürgen, just on the lads that are missing at the moment, who do you think has got an outside chance of being ready for Brighton after the international break?
Curtis. And I think, and the other two, then Diogo and Trent, for the week after. Chance.
Stefan
is pretty much now in his pre-season to make him physically ready. So at the moment, if you feel something, it's not injury, it's intensity. So he's a young lad, so we have to make sure that he just makes that we don't use him before he's then really ready, because obviously what happened before was that the body was not 100% ready for the intensity the professional football is asking for. So he's much better, in a much better place now. He had a long time, unfortunately, a really long time to improve that. But that's where we have to wait now a little bit. But he's in his pre-season. I think he will be a part of team training as well after international break.
We asked you last time about Mo Salah, because he's hitting yet another record. He has a great record against Manchester United. I think no one scored more goals than him in this fixture. How good is it that you've got him back in great shape for
us? That's super good. You saw it last night. How many goals did he set up first half? He scored and then was involved in all the others pretty much. Exceptional. So it was in a strange game second half. I would have loved to take him off. It was then not possible because of Bobby's situation. And of course he could manage that pretty well. But even then he set up another goal which was offside. But it's Mo is pure quality. And ask him what he likes the most about Manchester United. But the more we talk about it, the less likely it is that it will happen tomorrow again. So that's why I don't like these objects too much. But it's just an exceptional guy, world class player, and yes, how we dealt without him is unbelievable. unbelievable. The boys did really well, but it's better to have him around and on the pitch than just in the dressing room. So, no, good. And we could build it now with minutes. And yeah, he is ready for Sunday. Welcome.